Welcome to the last installment of Omni Calculator's mini-series on how to cool your drinks faster with science. Today is all about comparing our hacks with some standard methods of cooling and with no cooling. We will be analyzing the hacks and deciding which is the most practical, which one is the fastest, and if they even make sense to try. If you're interested in the individual hacks, remember we have a playlist with all the details for each individual hack. Like the video if you enjoy practical science, subscribe to see more practical science, and leave a comment with your cooling tips. Now, let's get to it! Today, we will be doing 5 tests related to the hacks we explained before. The first test would be no test, or as we call it in science, control. That would be a can and a glass of water left outside, no cooling at all. Then I would put a can of metal in the fridge, because we know that metal and glass cool almost at the same speed in the fridge. I put glass and metal in the freezer to see if that would make any difference. And then I also have a couple of metal can and glass bottles that I bathe in ice water and salt to see what's the difference between both of them. As I mentioned before, we're not using definitely not beer today. We're instead using water. Because water is the main component of beer, soft drinks, and, well, water, which are the most common things you would want to cool on a summer day. Now, all there's left to do is wait and see what the results are. For the control test, the fridge and the freezer, I left them for a whole hour just to see the effect, because we don't expect them to be very quick. But for the ice baths, both with and without salt, I left only 10 minutes because I know their cooling power is much greater. Once the hour has passed, we open the bottle and the can and start getting results. For the one that was studying in the shadow, once we let the thermometer settle at a stable temperature, it reads 20.8 Celsius. The bottle, slightly warmer, probably due to the color, 22.3. Now, time for the fridge. Should be much colder, but in science we always need to do the experiment, so let's hope it's good. Opening the can, putting the thermometer and waiting until it settles at a decent temperature reveals no real improvement. Yes, it's colder, but not much. Now time for the freezer. Hopefully this would be better than the fridge, but again, experiment is king here. Once again, we open both containers and we let the thermometer reach an equilibrium temperature. Here, 0.4 Celsius for the metal can, and the bottle, once again, it's slightly warmer. We get a very good 1.5 Celsius temperature. Now time for the stars of the show, the ice bath. We put them in. Once the 10 minutes have passed, we take them out of the bucket and we proceed to measure their temperature. Again, we have to wait until the thermometer reaches a stable temperature. In this case, 4.3 for the can. And once again, the glass bottle is slightly warmer at around 7.45 Celsius. Now we take the packet of salt that we had before and we add it all. We mix thoroughly and we wait for the temperature in the bath to drop. Then we put the drinks inside. Notice how the metal can floats more than before due to the salt dissolving the water. After 10 minutes, we take them out. I was having some issues here. I'll explain why in a moment, but for now, let's just measure the glass bottle and see what the results are. Once the temperature reaches a stable value, we see 0.3 Celsius. I'm showing here how the liquid is still, well, liquid. And the reason I'm doing that is because inside of the can, it wasn't. As you can see here, part of it froze solid, meaning the temperature inside of the can dipped below 0 Celsius. So yes, for anyone doubting, this hack works. It cools your drinks faster and it makes your life easier, unless you're me. There's no hack for fixing clumsiness, I guess. And now that we have the results, we can start drawing conclusions. I see two main lessons here. The first one is that, as we knew, metal is way faster at cooling drinks than glass. We've seen it throughout the experiments and it's undeniable. If you can, use a metal can. The second lesson is that if you're after all-out speed, nothing beats ice, water, and salt. When they're combined together, they make for the fastest cooling method. If for some reason you don't have enough ice or salt is just for cooking in your house, then the freezer seems like a good alternative, taking about an hour to cool our drinks as much as it's reasonable. However, I would like to make a comment on these results. This is not the ultimate answer to the cooling drink. There are many factors that we cannot control and that can vary your results if you would do it yourself. For example, my fridge was full and I couldn't put the drinks close to the compressor where they would have gotten colder faster. The freezer, however, it was almost empty and I could put the drinks just right at the top shelf, which is the coldest one. So that explains part of the difference in the results. If you really want to have an all-encompassing answer, then check out the calculator I made. There you can compare and simulate all different types of cooling and all different situations. And even though it's not perfect, because all these factors we cannot take into account, it's still very useful for planning ahead, knowing what to do, and deciding which is the cooling hack you want to use this day. As for the series, this is the end of it, so a like would be appreciated, subscribe if you love science, and I will see you in the next video, which will be very different to anything we've done before. Until then, have a nice day, bye!